Adam and Katarina, as you know, I've known you guys a long time. I remember when you were, that little. And when I heard that the two of you were dating, I thought to myself, that's interesting. Of course, we had already moved away, and we were gone for a couple years, so we didn't get to see the continuation of that friendship and relationship. But I wanted to show you what I have in my notes for pastoral message. What's there?
Nothing.
I do have something in my head. So. But I wanted to show you that because that's like a blank page, right? That's what every day after today is. It's a blank page. God has written your story up to this point, but the pages ahead are blank to us, although God knows those. All right? And the beauty is you get to live through those pages as God writes the story. And that's going to be a beautiful thing. So here's what's not written on the page. Scripture tells us, and you know, because we've talked about this quite a bit over the last number of months as we've met. And again, thank you guys for the privilege of Tina and I being able to meet with you guys and help prepare, not for today, right? But for a lifetime ahead. Scripture tells us that the two become one, right? There's a unity that needs to be part of your marriage that can only be marked by what God is doing in it. And that unity is so important because as wonderful as today is, even if there's hiccups along, this is a glorious day. There's going to be some days that you face that aren't so glorious as a couple. I don't know what they're going to be or why they're going to be, but there'll be speed bumps along the way. There'll be hurdles you'll need to get over. And if you're not as one, those speed bumps, instead of you huddling together figuratively, maybe literally, but instead of you guys kind of grabbing onto each other and holding on over those speed bumps can bounce you apart. And so when Scripture says the two become one, that's so comprehensive that God really desires the two to become one. When Paul wrote in the New Testament, he talked about how he was building. And I'm sure one of the things, you may not phrase it this way, but you want to build a life together, right? And Paul said, there's no other foundation that I can legitimately build on than that of what Jesus Christ has done. And it's on that foundation that I build. Because if I build on anything else, even if it's with fine metals and costly precious stones and all that, that all comes crumbling down. And so you have to remember always, always, what you're building on is a foundation that Christ laid for you. That's the only foundation you can build on that will last. So you have to always keep that in mind. One of the last things Jesus prayed for when he prayed for whatever he felt like praying for before he left this earth, he prayed for the unity of believers. So we recognize that unity is not only important in marriage, but it's also just so near and dear to God's heart. And so you'll have to work at it. You'll have to work at it because it's hard. Because you're two imperfect people, right? He's not perfect. I mean, you're not. But no one wants to say the other one's not perfect. But we would agree, two imperfect people trying to have a perfect relationship. And you know what the difference is? It's what Christ does. That's what God does, bringing the two of you together. And so always remember that that oneness, that unity is so near and dear to God's heart. And if it's that important to God because of your faith, it ought to be that important to the two of you. But God will develop that. You know each other the least today of your married lives. Think about it. Like the least of your married lives. That's a blank page ahead. But at the bottom of that page is what Christ has done for each of you. That's the bottom line. That's what you build on. And that's what will get you past today and will keep you strong on the days ahead. So that it's not just a nice wedding, but it's a healthy marriage. And it's a marriage that does all the things that we talked about over the last couple months, right? It's one that honors God. It's one that sets an example for others. It's one in which God uses each of you in the lives of each other, because what he's doing is his work in each of you is now through the other person as well. So keep all those things in mind. I'm sure you'll forget them as soon as, you know, I say amen, but that's what you need to keep in mind. And I know you guys will do great. I have confidence in that. And part of that confidence is not just in the two of you, but it's in God. Because if he really is authoring the story, then he will sustain you. So always lean on him. Lean into each other, but together you have to lean on him. All right? Can I pray for you guys?
Yes.
All right. Would you like to join me in a word of prayer for Adam and Katerina? Father, so grateful for these two. I'm grateful for their trust in you, first and foremost, that they have put their faith in you. And because of that faith, they lean into you so hard. I pray, God, that you would, now as they lean into each other, that you would indeed unify them. Bring them a unity that is marked by your presence in their lives. And we pray, God, that the foundation you have laid for them, the relationship they have with you, that as they build on that together, Lord, it would be strong. And it would be strong when the difficulties of life come, and it'd be strong when they're on the mountaintops of life. And we pray your blessing would shower over them and their relationship, their family, the home that they build. Lord, we're so grateful that we can entrust them to you because of their faith in you and because of our confidence in who you are as a good, good, loving God. Thank you, God, for what you're doing. Continue your work. We pray in Christ's name. Amen. Adam and Katerina, you have vows that you wish to make to one another today?
Yes, we do.
I, Adam Eric, take you, Katerina Ann, to be my wife. Today you are mine and I am yours. I vow to hold your hand forever and remind you that your beauty is deeper than makeup. As we grow old, I will remind you that you mean so much to me. I vow to lead you with strong hands as God is leading me. I will protect you from harm and work to provide for you. This commitment that we are making today means that whatever comes in life, we face it together. Hand in hand, that whether we are laughing or crying, confident or anxious, running or just barely standing, it will be together, you and me. Katerina, I vow to love you in sickness and in health, for richer or poorer, for better or for worse, from this day forward, as long as we both shall live.
I, Katerina Ann, take you, Adam Eric, to be my husband. Today I choose you. I will become yours and you will become mine. All of your past and all of your future. We are not perfect, but I vow to learn from our mistakes. Adam, I vow to respect you, as God has called wives to respect their husbands. I pray that God would continually heal my wounds through his love so that I can hold my arms wide open for you. This commitment that we are making today means that whatever happens in life, we face it together, hand in hand. Whether we are laughing or crying, confident or anxious, running or just barely standing, it will be together, you and me. I will stand by your side in sickness and in health, for richer or poorer, for better or worse, from this day forward, as long as we both shall live.
Adam and Katerina, do you have symbols of the vows you make to one another today? In case you're wondering, John has handed up a ring that was, I'm sure, carefully chosen and is something that you will wear that means so much more than just a piece of jewelry. It represents not only your commitment to one another, but it is a symbol to those who would see that your heart is spoken for. So Adam, if you would place that on the third finger of her left hand, repeat after me. I give you this ring.
I give you this ring.
As a symbol of my love and commitment.
As a symbol of my love and commitment.
Today and forever.
Today and forever.
Katerina, you have a symbol of the vows you make today. Okay. Was anyone else expecting that to go down the line? So as well, I'm sure, carefully chosen to represent the fact that your heart is spoken for and that your commitment is sure. Katerina, repeat after me. I give you this ring.
This ring.
As a symbol of my love and commitment.
As a symbol of my love and commitment.
Today and forever.
Today and forever.
Well, Adam and Katerina, based on the vows you make to one another today before God and these witnesses, by the power vested in me in New York State, but more importantly, by our Lord as a minister of the gospel in his name, I do pronounce that you are husband and wife. Adam, you may kiss your bride. It is my privilege to present to you for the very first time, Mr. and Mrs. Adam Eric Osbach.
Money won't pay these bills. Time will show.